for a meditation is living in the Spirit of God. As we begin, a small challenge for you. How long can you hold your breath for? How long? 10 seconds? Definitely not 10 minutes. As we think on this, we remember with sadness in our hearts Mr. George Floyd, who cried out, "I can't breathe," as those heartless officers stripped away the breath of life from him. As we reflect on this incident, we realize the value of breathing, the value of breath, oxygen, the air we breathe. In the creation story, we find in Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And the man became a living being. We see how God breathes into humanity the breath of life. It's very interesting when we think on this. God breathes into us the breath of life. Now this word breath in the Hebrew language is called ruah. So God shares his ruah with us, with humanity. And we begin to breathe, to live. It is in this moment when God breathes into us his ruah, humanity begins to live. Now ruah, which means breath, also means Spirit of God. So ruah means breath and also Spirit of God. We see this reference of ruah as the Spirit of God in Genesis chapter 1 verse 2. Once again we reflect on the creation story. Genesis chapter 1 verse 2. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. The Ruah of God was moving over the waters. The Ruah of God was moving over the chaos of the earth. The Ruah of God, the Spirit of God, moves in places of chaos and darkness, bringing forth life and light. So it is this Ruah that God breathes into humanity. The Spirit of God is shared with humanity, is breathed into humanity, and this affirms life. An important truth to remember: we are truly made alive when the Spirit of God begins to move in us. We are truly alive, we are born, made a new creation when the Ruah of God begins to work within us. So life begins when the Spirit of God is moving in us. Now this happens because the Spirit of God works in conflict, in opposition with chaos, darkness, evil that surrounds us, that tries to work within us. In Galatians chapter 5, verses 16 and 17, we see Paul writing to the Galatians, reminding them, "So I say, live by the Spirit, and you will not gratify the desires of the sinful nature. For the sinful nature desires what is contrary to the Spirit, and the Spirit what is contrary to the sinful nature. They are in conflict with each other, so that you may not do what you want. We see in this text how the sinful nature works in contrary, in opposition, in conflict with the Spirit of God. Therefore, to live in the Spirit is to oppose the way of the sinful heart. It is to oppose the sinful nature, oppose what is evil. We live in a culture that people are addicted to pornography, the culture of pornography. The way of death is only a click away. And whenever we give in to this addiction, we are living in opposite to the way of the Spirit. The community that gossips, the community that carries tales of one another, that spreads rumors, the community that works to bring others down, a disunited community, works in opposite to the Spirit of God. Let us look at ourselves, at our communities. Are we living in the Spirit? The Holy Spirit working in our lives affirms life in us and our community. Living in the Spirit produces a counterculture. This is the fruit of the Spirit. Now, when the fruit of the Spirit is working in us, we witness a counterculture being produced. A counterculture to that culture of hatred and violence, to the culture of lovelessness. We see in Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 and 23. The fruit of the Spirit. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. When the Spirit of God is living and working in us, we produce the fruits of the Spirit. This is the counterculture. A counterculture of love that goes beyond the barriers of race, religion, and even the color of one's skin. A counterculture that calls us to live in peace with one another. When it is hard to live in peace, the Holy Spirit prompts us to do so. When it is easy to hate our Muslim brothers and sisters after the Easter terror attacks, to look at every one of them as terrorists, the Holy Spirit helps us to live in peace with each other. When it is easy to point fingers and play the blame game, like what we see today, in relation to the COVID-19 situation, the blame game of pointing the finger at China for creating this virus. Sometimes governments play the blame game of pointing fingers at the people for blaming, for spreading the virus. So this pointing fingers matter, blaming each other, happens in our society. It is easy. But the Holy Spirit challenges us to be patient with one another, to be gentle with one another. to show a goodness that fails to, that holds back from accusing each other. When it is easy to speak hurtful words, to hurt the feelings, to be rude to our neighbor, the Holy Spirit produces in us the fruit of kindness, the fruit of love and gentleness. COVID-19 has made us all poor in a way. The economic struggle is very real for all of us. But to some it is much more than to others. Some are suffering much more than certain others. In this reality, it is the Holy Spirit that produces in us a spirit of generosity to share our resources with those in need. This is the fruit of the Spirit working in us. This is the counterculture that is born when the Spirit is working within us. The fruit of the Spirit in us produces this counterculture. We become an alternate community. This is the challenge for us. To live in the Spirit is to live a counterculture, to be an alternate community. Today, many of us can't come to church, can't gather in church to worship God. But the challenge is to open a church in our homes, to be the church in our communities. The Spirit of God living and working in us calls us to be the church. To live in the Spirit is to be the church. We must be a witness in community. In Acts chapter 1 verse 8 we see Jesus saying, "When the Holy Spirit comes on you, you will be given power to be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, and in Samaria, and in all the ends of the earth." So the Holy Spirit gives us power to be a witness to the love of Christ, to be the church in our communities, to be a counterculture, the alternate community. Let us be empowered by the Holy Spirit. Let us understand what it means to live in the Spirit. To live in the Spirit is to be born to a new life. The Ruah of God gives us life. A life that is a countercultural way of living that makes us the alternate community. May God help us to be so. Come, Holy Spirit, be